the effects of slavery in the United States persist. And those effects persist in large measure because the United States never has provided restitution for slavery.
At the end of the Civil War, here was a terrific moment when reparations could have been paid, and then the black people were given nothing. The denial of the 40-acre land grants for black Americans was a huge moment. For us, that is where the racial wealth gap is born. You know, that's the origin story.
We like to say that the racial wealth gap is the best economic indicator of the cumulative intergenerational effects of white supremacy in the United States.
When the nation made a decision to establish itself as a republic that legalized slavery. I mean, that didn't have to be the case. We could have begun as a nation where everyone was free.
So it's the federal government who has the responsibility, and it's the federal government that has the capability.